Hello and welcome to my class. In this video, I am going to give you a comparative account of three pests of sugarcane: Pyrrhella purpursilla or sugarcane leafhopper, Scipophaga nivella or sugarcane top borer, and Chilo infascatilis or sugarcane stem borer. I have made individual videos for each of these pests, but here I am going to present a comparative account which will help you in remembering the pest biology more clearly, as well as it will also help you in distinguishing one pest from another. So let's start. First, I will talk about the systematic position. For Pyrrhella purpursilla, it belongs to phylum Arthropoda, subphylum Uniremia, class Insecta, subclass Pterygota, division Exopterygota, order Hemiptera, suborder Homoptera, family Fulgoridae or Lophopidae, genus Pyrrhella and species Pyrrhella purpursilla. Please remember that up to subclass Pterygota, all insects in your syllabus at least will have the same systematic position. So till subclass, everything will be same, but from division it will change. If the insect has a nymphal stage in its life cycle, then it develops its wing buds externally. So in that case, they belong to division Exopterygota. If the insects have the larval and pupal stages in their life cycle, then in the larva, the wings first develop internally, then externally. So they belong to division Endopterygota. Now for orders, Pyrrhella belongs to order Hemiptera or the order of the bugs and suborder Homoptera. In case of suborder Homoptera, the wings at rest are folded on the body like a roof. So you should look at that character and then you can put it under suborder Homoptera. Then family is Fulgoridae or Lophopidae. Some authors earlier used to classify it under family Fulgoridae, but now authors use family Lophopidae for Pyrrhella. It belongs to genus Pyrrhella and species is Pyrrhella purpursilla or P. purpursilla. Please make sure that when you write the species name, you either write the genus initial or the whole genus name and then the species name. Only this name does not mean anything. Another thing that I want you to remember is that the systematic position should always be written in a slant, not starting from the same longitudinal line. So you should not start the phylum from this point. Instead, you should leave a little space here and then you should start writing phylum Arthropoda. Okay. Now, next is Scipophaga nivella. It belongs to order Lepidoptera. Lepidoptera means the order which will include moths and butterflies who have scaly wings. Lepido means scales and pteran means wings. So Lepidoptera comes from, the insects get the order name Lepidoptera because they are scaly wings. Okay. Now, both these are moths, so they both belong to order Lepidoptera. Their family names are also same, Pyrrhellidae or Crambidae. Some authors put them under family Pyrrhellidae, some authors classify them under family Crambidae. So, I have given both the names here. For this, genus is Scipophaga and species is Scipophaga nivella. For this, genus is Chilo and species is Chilo infascatilis. Now let's talk about the life cycle and the damaging phase. Now the life cycle of Pyrrhella is different from the life cycle of Scipophaga and Chilo. In case of Pyrrhella's life cycle, you would find the adult stage, the egg stage and the nymphal stages or the nymphal molds. In case of Scipophaga and Chilo, you would find the larva and pupal stage. Okay. In case of Pyrrhella purpursilla, both adult and nymph cause damage by sucking the plant sap from the midrib of the leaves. In case of Scipophaga nivella, only the larval stage is injurious to the plants and they feed the growing tissue of the stem. Remember, Scipophaga nivella's common name is sugarcane top borer. So it affects the stem at the top part and that's why they feed on the growing tissue of the stem. Chilo infascatilis is the sugarcane stem borer. So it makes tunnel inside the stem and it can feed on the tissue anywhere in the stem. Let's look at how these insects cause damage to sugarcane plants. Spirilla purpusilla, as I said, they suck the plant sap from the leaves. As a result, the leaves become brown and dry. Also, these insects secrete honeydew from their anal end. This honeydew or a sugary secretion gets spread on the leaves. Now, these leaves become resource rich because they have this sugary secretion on them, and that attracts fungal growth. Once black sooty mold grow on the leaves, those leaves cannot get enough light for photosynthesis. As a result, the leaf becomes black and it cannot produce food for the plant anymore. For Scirpophaga nivella, they are sugarcane top border. They attack the top part of the stem, right? They show three symptoms. First is gunshot-like wounds. Like this, in the central leaf, you would see the gunshot-like wounds, and in the center, the central shoot would die because the larvae feed on the growing tissue of the stem. As a result, the plant cannot grow vertically anymore. So it will have a dead heart. You can see a picture of dead heart here as well. The central shoot is dead. And next symptom of Scirpophaga nivella attack is, since the plant cannot grow vertically towards up, what happens is more branches start coming out from the top part. So you get a bunch of growing shoots at the top, which is known as the bunchy top. In case of Kylo, of course you get the dead heart because the internal stem tissue is eaten up by the Kylo larva, so it cannot grow any more in the center, so this part would die. This is known as dead heart. Also, Kylo infuscatilus larvae make holes in the stem. They make tunnels inside the stem as well, and they can come out from one plant and they can attack another plant. That way, they cause damage to multiple plants. Okay, so you would see these boring holes on the stem as well as the tunnels inside the stem. The quality of the cane would deteriorate, as well as the quantity of sugar will be decreased because of Kylo attack. It is most injurious to the young plants. If Kylo attack happens in young plants, then most of these plants would die. Now let's talk about how we can control these three pests. For Spirilla purpusilla, we can use either chemical or biological control. Because these insects are seen outside the plant, we can use chemicals very easily, and we can also use biological control. Okay. For moths, we can use light trap, pheromonal trap, etc. Because moths are nocturnal, they get attracted towards light. So then you can trap the adults and kill them. Also, the males get attracted towards the female pheromone. So, if the pheromone is there is a pheromone trap made where you can use synthetically made pheromones, the insects will get attracted towards that pheromone and then they can be captured and killed. Also, in case of Spirilla purpusilla, they do not hibernate, they are found throughout the year. So you cannot control it by moving the period of cultivation or moving the period of harvesting. However, for Scirpophaga nivella and Kylo infuscatilus, the larvae hibernate in winter. They pupate at the end of winter and then they come out in March. So what we need to do here is that we have to avoid that window when the insects come out of their pupa. If our plants are mature enough, before these adults are ready to lay eggs, or these hibernated adults are ready to lay eggs, then at least most of our crop will be safe from these attacks. Okay. Also, we can use resistant variety of crop. Biotechnologically, many sugar canes are produced which are resistant to Scirpophaga and Kylo attack. So we can use those kind of sugar canes for culturing in our field. Hope you like this video and hope this comparative account will help you in remembering the biology of each pest, as well as it will help you in differentiating one pest from the other. Please come back for pests of cotton.